Hey there guys, today we're going to be taking a dive into the complex world of 3D printer firmware, specifically the battle for your 3D printer between Klipper and Marlin. And I'm going to humbly try to break this down for you so you can make an informed decision on which one is best for you. So essentially your 3D printer is a lifeless hunk of stepper motors and metal. It's the firmware that really brings your 3D printer to life. The firmware is responsible for reading the G-code and sending electrical impulses to your stepper motors to drive your 3D printer. Behind the scenes, the firmware is constantly crunching millions of calculations to control the printer's various parts, including stepper motors, fans, and heaters. And with new 3D printers and advancing technology coming out all the time, the firmware is under increasing pressure to perform. And Klipper and Marlin have risen to the forefront of this battle for supremacy, and understanding the differences between them will give you powerful leverage if you want to up your game and streamline your printer for maximum efficiency. And in this video, I'm going to give you an overview of each one, go over pros and cons, and look into the best use cases in my personal opinion, so you can figure out what's best for you. So stick around and let's get into it. Okay, so let's talk about our old friend Marlin. Marlin is a widely used open source firmware that's super popular with a ton of 3D printing enthusiasts. It was first developed in 2011 and has since become the go-to choice for most 3D printing manufacturers for a reason. Marlin is very flexible and has a ton of customization options. This means you can tweak and adjust your settings to your liking. This makes it a popular choice for people who want complete control over their printer settings and performance. Marlin also offers a bunch of features including thermal protection, power loss and recovery, and auto bed leveling. This can help ensure that your printer is consistent, that your prints are high quality, and that your printer doesn't catch fire, which is a super useful feature in my opinion. Another huge advantage of Marlin is its compatibility with a ton of 3D printers and hardware. And with a huge, powerful community behind Marlin, it makes it super easy to find the exact upgrades you want to install and use. In other words, you can basically run it on an 8-bit potato. Performance-wise, Marlin is reliable and consistent. So it doesn't offer the same real-time processing capabilities as Klipper, but it can still be a really powerful firmware that can handle complex printing tasks. One of the downsides of Marlin, however, is that it's not close to as fast as Klipper. Because it uses your printer's main board to process the commands instead of using a dedicated external processing system like a Raspberry Pi or a computer. Which brings me to Klipper. So Klipper is a newer, more powerful open source firmware that's been gaining a whole bunch of popularity within the 3D printing world in the last couple of years. It's designed to be faster and more efficient than other firmware options, including Marlin. One of the main advantages of Klipper is its real-time processing capabilities. Instead of using your printer's main board to process commands like Marlin, Klipper offloads most of the processing to a more powerful external computer, like a Raspberry Pi. This allows your printer to process the G-code way more efficiently. A, because the external computer is way more powerful than even a 32-bit board. And B, your printer's main board is already bogged down trying to push out electric signals to your stepper motors and your fans and your heater and, you know, all the rest of this stuff. So once you take off all that load and export it to an external computer, that cuts the bottleneck right out and lets you print way faster and at much higher qualities. Klipper is also highly customizable. Similar to Marlin, however, it usually takes a little bit more technical knowledge to set up and use, since it involves configuring both the firmware on your 3D printer and the external computer interface. However, as opposed to Marlin, which every single upgrade and every change you want to make, you have to reflash updated firmware, with Klipper, you can essentially change all the printer config files straight from the user interface, which is awesome. So Klipper is also compatible with a whole ton of 3D printers, maybe not as many as Marlin, but a whole lot of them, making it a versatile option if you want to upgrade your 3D printing powers. And exporting all the motion calculation to an external computer makes your printing way faster. So hopefully now that you know a little bit about Klipper and Marlin, let's look at the pros and cons of each. But first, if you find that you're getting any value from this, it would be awesome if you could help me build this small community by subscribing and maybe even hitting that like button so I can keep getting better and bringing better content for you guys. And who knows, maybe even reach 1,000 subscribers. please bear with me because I just want to say thank you to all the people who have sent me some really, really nice comments. Guys, I really appreciate that. You have no idea. I sit there, I read some of these comments. I'm just like, oh my God, wow. You know, it really gives me a lot of motivation to keep doing this, you know? I really appreciate it. But anyway, enough about that. Let's get back into it. So let's jump back into it with some pros and cons about Marlin. So pro number one for Marlin is it has a huge, super active community of really passionate people that have been around for a long, long time on this firmware. The second, it's pretty simple to set up on your computer and flash. And if you don't know how to do that, there are some really simple step-by-step tutorials out there to teach you exactly what you need to know. Third, it has a whole bunch of customization options for your 3D printer. If you want to add another extruder or whatever it may be, there's probably some kind of add-on out there for Marlin, which makes life super easy. Fifth, it has a whole bunch of advanced features. Sixth, it's really stable and it has a long track record of being really stable and performing very well. Seven, Marlin is constantly being updated and improved. And eighth, if you want to use your printer from your PC, you can always use Octoprint, which is awesome in and of itself. That's for a whole nother video. But of course there's some cons too, especially when you're up against a competitor like Klipper. The biggest of those cons, in my personal opinion, is that you're limited to the power of your main board on your printer. All of the motion processing and all the commands to your stepper motors and your fans and your heater and everything is done on a tiny little board that can really bottleneck your print speed and your quality. The second con is that every single upgrade you do to your printer and everything you might want to change, if you want to update your Marlin, if you want to, anything you want might want to do, you got to reflash the firmware onto your printer, and that can get kind of annoying. The third thing is that while technically pressure advance and input shaping are supported, it is super annoying and very tedious to get these things up and running. And even once you do, they don't come close to the accuracy of pressure advance and input shaping on Klipper. And that brings us to the pros and cons of Klipper. As for Klipper, let's go into the pros. Pro number one is you can run it from a single board external computer, like a Raspberry Pi, and it supercharges your 3D printing abilities. The second pro is it has real-time trajectory and motion planning calculations for faster and more precise printing. The third thing is it has a high degree of customization and flexibility, and you don't have to flash firmware every time you want to do an upgrade or an update. You just change it with a printer config file straight into the Moonraker interface, which is really convenient and super easy. The fourth pro is you can use it straight from your PC natively. You can just type the IP in your web browser, up comes Moonraker, and you can send things off to be printed without any kind of trouble. It's super simple, and I would say even easier, in my opinion, than Octoprint. And if you still want to use Octoprint, you can always use OctoClipper, which is also an option that's out there for you. The fifth thing is it's compatible with a ton of 3D printers out there. A ton. And the last pro is that Klipper has native support for two of the most powerful tools to supercharge your 3D printing, and that is pressure advance and input shaping. Got a video on both of them. You can watch it next time. Got it down below in the description. I'll link it in the description. You can go for that. But now let's get into the cons. Klipper can be more complex and difficult to install on your 3D printer. So it may be, if you're not that tech savvy or advanced, you might not want to go for this option. The second con is it requires additional hardware to get up and running. In other words, you got to get a Raspberry Pi or some other external computer to run Klipper on your 3D printer. And the third con is that you might not even need to use all these extra settings and supercharge 3D printer superpowers and all the rest of that stuff Klipper comes with. Because if you're just basically printing things out every once in a while, you know, like a little benchy here or some toy for your kid or something like that, you might not necessarily really need Klipper on your 3D printer. if you're not, you know, trying to push it to its maximum capability. I mean, if you're fine with the way your 3D printer is working now, then Klipper might not be for you. But I'm assuming that if you're watching this video, you might be interested in it. And if you're interested in it, that might be because you might not be happy with your current 3D printing capabilities. And so I'm not 100% sure that that necessarily is relevant, but it's got to be said. So the truth is that both Marlin and Klipper are unbelievable, incredible firmware that you can run on your 3D printer. But bottom line, which firmware is best? Well, in my opinion, it comes down to three things: budget, experience, and how you use your printer. Let me explain. Since Marlin comes stock on most 3D printers nowadays, and the fact that you have to add an additional computer to get Klipper up and running, it's gonna cost you some extra money, which might not be worth it for you, especially if you don't know how to flash firmware onto your printer in the first place, and don't feel like spending the extra time learning how to install Clippy on a Raspberry Pi or using an image to flash Mainsail or Fluid Pi to your 3D printer, then you might want to stick to Marlin. However, Klipper has a new trick up its sleeve, and that is the Sonic Pad, which I reviewed in a separate video that I linked down in the description, along with some affiliate links for my most frequently used 3D printing gear, which you might want to check out. But at the end of the day, it all kind of boils down to how you want to use your 3D printer. If printing faster, higher quality prints while having an easier time 3D printing is what you're looking for, then in my personal opinion, Klipper is the way to go. But if you don't have the need to spend all kinds of extra money for a Sonic Pad or a Raspberry Pi, which is really expensive now, and you're happy with the way your printer is working, and you don't have the time to tinker around, then Marlin is the right option for you, in my opinion. Anyway, that's it for this video, guys. If you like that, you might like this one next. Take care for now. Bye-bye.